Buddha Dean gave me the beetle nut cure. And as I chewed upon the nut, things got clearer. Yes, Mulligan, yes! You are weak for the flesh. I will bring you the lust. Ah! And you will be mine, Mulligan. You have taken a step too far this time.
And welcome once again to Championship Wrestling 84. I'm Gordon Soley, your host. With me, Barbara Clary and Buddy Colt. And, Barbara, your take five concerns the gentleman we just saw on the screen.
That's right. The one-man gang is going to be with me to discuss some interesting things that have happened
to him. And they are interesting indeed. Buddy, on top of that, we've got some tremendous action upcoming during this hour.
That's right. One of the big matches today that you won't want to miss is there's going to be a big six-man tag team match with Blackjack Mulligan, Chief Joe Lightfoot, and Barry Windham going up against the team of Angelo Montez, Cowboy Ron Bass, and Black Bart. This is going to be an exciting match that you won't want to miss.
No question.
But, one other thing, Gord, you know, it seems like a lot of wrestling fans have been asking me about where is Mike Davis. I asked around some of the wrestlers in the dressing room earlier, and no one seems to know.
No, it's a mystery. I haven't been able to find out either, so if anybody does have a handle as to his location or whereabouts, so we'd appreciate having him contact us, at least let us know what's happening. Also, we'll be seeing the Guerrero brothers in action today and the breakdancers. There's something else.
I haven't seen them myself yet, but I'm really anxiously waiting for that.
They are indeed an interesting combination, and we'll be seeing them a little bit later on. And a little bit later, too, we're going to be talking to Billy Jack. And, in fact, I think I see him coming right now, so let's hold up for just a second and chat with this man, the gentleman who has come back after suffering a broken hand, but wants that Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Gordon, how you doing, man? Buddy, how you doing, man?
Billy.
How's your hip doing?
Coming along just fine.
Okay, fantastic. Look, I came here from the Northwest, and how are all your fans doing, by the way? Because I love Florida, the way you've been treating me, and I'm wrestling for you all the way. All I want to say right straight to the point is I want the Florida heavyweight belt back around my waist because I represent the people. I lost the belt because of my hand, but I'm not going to make any excuses. Billy Graham's the only man to pin my shoulders to the master. I've been here in Florida. I don't care if it's Jacksonville, Sarasota, Lakeland, Tampa, St. Petersburg, wherever the match is going to be signed, where it's going to be in a cage, whatever it's going to be, I don't care. But I want the belt around my waist because I'm Billy Jack, the people's choice, and I'm fighting for y'all people out there. That's really all I got to say. I hope you get a lot better, Gordon. You're a fantastic man and the best announcer in professional wrestling. And Buddy Cole, likewise, my friend.
Thank you, Doc.
Billy Jack, thank you so very much. And certainly let's hope that we see that Florida Heavyweight Championship belt back around Billy Jack's waist in the very, very near future. There's certainly an open challenge has been made to the superstar Billy Graham. Let's go back now to the Orlando, the Eddie Graham Sports Stadium in Orlando, Florida, and pick up the conclusion of the match between Mike Rotundo and the One Man Gang.
The referee is asking the one-man gang if he wants to give it up, if he wants to submit, because right now it's going to be up to the one. Looks like the one-man gang is able to come out, but no, Mike Rotundo able to pull him right back in there. He's got his toe. He's pushing his toe around. He's got this toe hold on the great leg, a great spine. The one-man gang is grimacing in pain. Just look at the expression on his face. You can hear him screaming, hear him squealing. Look at that face. He is in a lot of pain right now. He's going to have to do something very fast. I don't know how much longer he can take this pressure on his leg.
Meantime, Rotundo, and it may be that that fatigue is really setting in on Rotundo, because thus far he's unable to put the one-man gang away, but he is hanging in tenaciously. You talk about tremendous spirit, great intestinal fortitude. This Mike Rotundo has it, no question about it. To his feet, but he's got problems. He has got problems, but he catches Rotundo on the top of the head. Rotundo's eyes glaze, and it's Rotundo caught right above our broadcast table. Rotundo's across the back. Gets him back in that thoracic region, and one to the side of Rotundo goes back with an elbow to the ample midriff of the one-man gang, and Rotundo again up against those ring ropes right above us.
Well, it seems like Rotundo right now is starting to show some fatigue from all this long, trying wrestling that he has done tonight. He's going to have to do something to try and get his win back, get away from the one-man gang, lay down, roll out on the floor, take an 8 or a 9 count, and come back into the ring. Seems like the one-man gang's left leg has been injured, but Mike Rotundo is going to have to do something to get the one-man gang off his feet and back down on his back again.
And it may be just a little bit too late. Rotundo trying to get that adrenaline going again, and the crowd responding to it as Mike Rotundo circles the ring and comes up. Wow! He caught the one-man gang with everything that he had. And again, Rotundo powering away. Rotundo staggers the one-man gang. He's got him in trouble. Gets him top of the head, the back of the top of the head. Drop kick, and the one-man gang is almost all the way through the ropes. The one-man gang in trouble and almost all the way through the ropes. And time is rapidly running out on this hour of Championship Wrestling 84. Mike Rotundo closes in again. And it is Rotundo dropping the one-man gang back to the canvas.
This is a grueling match. I don't know how Mike Rotundo has been able to stay up under this pressure for so long. Mike Rotundo had wrestled a match earlier, prior to this, where he would wrestle probably at least 20 minutes. He came back in the ring to going up against the one-man gang, and now they're about 25 minutes in this match, and both of these men are having to get very weary, very tired. The strain on your body from wrestling, remember, and professional wrestling is not like football or baseball or boxing. Boxing, every 3 minutes you get a minute break. Right here, there's 450 pounds on his shoulders.
He has got him up in the airplane spin, and this is absolutely broken up by Sir Oliver Humperdinck, and the referee immediately calling for the bell. And wait a minute. Mike Rotundo devastated by Sir Oliver Humperdinck and by the one-man gang. And a lot of vicious punishment being put down here. The referee quickly disqualifying.
Well, you know, Gordon, sometimes I don't think a disqualification or something like this is quite enough. There should be more involved in that. Mike Rotundo, with that airplane spin, that's his pinning combination. He had a 450-pounder defeated.
Two great nights of wrestling upcoming. This coming Wednesday night, Championship Wrestling returns to Miami Beach in the Miami Beach Convention Center. And on Saturday night, July 21st, Championship Wrestling will be held in Fort Lauderdale at the Sunrise Musical Theater. Now let's listen to these comments from Barbara Clary.
Miércoles, el 18 de julio, a las 8 de la noche, en Centro de Convenciones de Miami Beach, la lucha libre de campeones presentará para el título de Florida, Dusty Rhodes contra Superstar Billy Graham y 7 luchas más. Miércoles, el 18 de julio, a las 8 de la noche, en el Centro de Convenciones en Miami Beach.
Now this coming Wednesday night in Miami Beach in the Florida Championship match, Dusty Rhodes takes on Superstar Billy Graham. In a special grudge match, the one-man gang has Cowboy Ron Bass. Blackjack Mulligan and Chief Joe Lightfoot face Black Bart and Angelo Mosca. In a special attraction, it'll be Barry Windham versus Kevin Sullivan. There will be four other matches, rather. And, of course, at the Sunrise Musical Theater, A Night with the Stars upcoming on the 21st. And in a U.S. Tag Team Championship return match, it'll be Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo taking on Hector and Chavo Guerrero. The other matches, as you can see, were being flashed on the screen. I wanted to take a moment now to talk to Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo about that two very important nights of wrestling.
Well, you know, the one we're looking for is the one against the Guerreros, really. Mike and our team that night were defending our United States Tag Team Championship. I mean, the two Guerreros have always got something up their sleeve. They're always trying to pull something, a foot on a rope, trying to pull your tights, and we're watching you too. And you're not going to walk away with the title. on that Saturday night.
You're going to have to pull something awful, awful sneaky to get away with these titles, Guerrero, because we've seen it all from you guys. And Barry and I will, I repeat, we will be ready for you in Fort Lauderdale.
Right.
Buddy, it was about 4 months ago, if I remember correctly, that the one-man gang and Dusty Rhodes had a match here on television that ended up as a total disaster for the one-man gang.
Well, it really did. It seemed like the ligaments were torn in the one-man gang's knee and the leg there, and he was out of action for just about 2 months where he couldn't participate in wrestling at all.
Hey, what we're going to do, just to give you an indication of the kind of resiliency this man does have, though, let's go back in time now, again, and this time about 4 months ago when Dusty Rhodes faced the 450-pound one-man gang here on Championship Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match one fellow with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Chicago, Illinois, 450-pound one-man gang. His opponent, entering the ring from Tampa, Florida, weighing at 260 pounds, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Okay, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, facing the one-man gang. The match we mentioned earlier on in the program about the great matches, and boy, the one-man gang brought Rhodes in that corner and drove him to the mat. One-man gang at 450 pounds, still punishing Rhodes. And Rhodes outside the ring and the one-man gang right after it.
Well, you know, Gordon, this here would be a main event in any arena in the entire country, and the one-man gang is chasing Dusty Rhodes out into the audience. There has been absolutely no wrestling thus far in this match. All just in the hands of the one-man gang, complete mayhem.
Rhodes in trouble now as the one-man gang closes in on him once again in the ring. Rhodes catches him with the elbow. And Rhodes now a swinging left hand, another and another and another. And now Rhodes winds up. Bottom. A mule kick right to the midsection. That bionic elbow to the top of the head, but the one-man gang rips across the face of Dusty Rhodes. Rhodes caught and driven back to the canvas. The one-man gang, and watch out. Ring almost gave way. Rhodes caught him, and it's Rhodes going for the Eddie Graham figure four. Dusty Rhodes has got the Eddie Graham figure four leg lock on him. He's got it on him. It was and the one man gang conceding. The one man gang conceding. Ooh, Rhodes clamps down again. Rhodes refusing to relinquish that figure four. And the one-man gang trying to rise up, but he is in tremendous agony here. And it looks like his knee may have gone. It looks like his knee may have gone. The one-man gang, there you see the victor, Dusty Rhodes. Down on that knee again. And it looks to me like the one-man gang has got some pretty serious damage to that knee.
You know, Gordon, this here is the same hole that Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer broke Ray Harris' leg with just a couple weeks ago. This is a damaging hole. There is virtually no escaping once this hole is applied in the center of the ring. One of the very few holes for which there is no counter.
Well, it was a hole that Eddie Graham used and perfected. And I'll tell you what, it has proven to be so highly effective. And it is apparent here that the one-man gang is not able to walk. So the ligaments of the cartilage, possibly in that knee, have been ripped or have been stretched to a point where that's 450 pounds that they're going to have to try and load up on a stretcher. And and he is in tremendous pain, as you can tell. You can't even stand to have anybody touch it, but they've got to get him up on that stretcher.
There's your beef right there, Gordon. There's your beef,
Jenny. Those are the comments of Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. And there's the beef.
That's me in
car number 18, a Mercury Capri. I'm Lynn St. James, and I always pick a top performer like Hollywood Lincoln Mercury. You know, it's not just the car you drive, but the backup you get that really makes the difference. And whether you get a new Mark 7, Marquis, Cougar, Lynx, or a fine used car, you'll get top performance in sales and service at Hollywood Lincoln Mercury. Make a pit stop here and see for yourself. On US 1, it's Sheridan.
The one-man gang is joining in the death. You've just seen his leg broken by Dusty Rhodes. Rhodes expect and receive numerous injuries, and this man has got a reputation for never backing down from any confrontation. It was common knowledge that he was in the corner of Sir Oliver Humperdinck. Some even suggested that he was maybe under the influence of Kevin Sullivan. But something happened in Lakeland to change that. So let's take a look now at the return match of Dusty Rhodes and the one-man gang in the Lakeland Civic Center.
It was an accident. I landed on top of Humperdinck. You know, just, I don't realize what had happened. I get up and it was just an accident. So Humperdinck, he's out of it. So I'm just there. I am trying to help the man out of the ring. So the match is still going on. You know, it's just no disqualification. So the match is still going on. Humperdinck's out of it.
So you think that it would be your responsibility to continue with the match?
Sure, it's my responsibility. I'm out there trying to defeat the man. That's what Humperdinck always told me to do, is win any way you can win. So, it was accident, like I said, but I'm trying to continue the match, trying to defeat the man, because that's where the big bucks is. You win the match, you get some big bucks. The match is continuing, you know. Rhodes is busted open, he's bleeding, and we're just trading it back and forth. And so, that's all it is right now, is just a back and forth match.
In the meantime, Humperdinck is still in the ring.
You see right there, we had both of us go down. Rhodes is out on the floor. Here I am. I'm a little dazed right now. Right there, you see Humperdinck and Superstar and Cowboy Ron Bass come out there. You know, I'm out there. I think they're giving Humperdinck aid, like anybody would think. Right here, boom. Superstar crowding me in the back, puts the full Nelson on me. There goes Ron Bass. He's got his cowboy boot in his hand, right in the head, again and again right there. I have no idea where I'm at. I'm out of it right there. Both men right there in the ring. Humperdinck's over there in the floor. He's laughing about it. Ron Bass is taking his belt off. I have no idea where I'm at. I'm just, I'm laying there. I'm out of it. Right, I didn't even realize who it was at the time. You know, I was just in the ring. I didn't realize who it was until I saw the videotape. And they're just, what can you say? They're beating the fool out of me right here.
Apparently Humperdinck wasn't injured nearly as badly as...
No, the way it seems to me is these two men came out to aid Humperdinck, and me and Humperdinck's been having a few words here and there anyways, but the way it seems to me, Humperdinck ordered Cowboy Ron Bass, the Superstar, to jump me from behind, and here I am in the middle of the ring. So, what can I say? Right there's the picture. Dusty Rhodes don't know what happened either. He's out on the floor. I had my back to the men. I don't know what happened. Like I said, till later, the VCR. I don't know what's going on. But this is later back in the... This is supposed to be my dressing room. This is my stuff they're throwing around. My personal goods, my valuables, my fur, my chain, all my clothes. This is, like I said, I'm totally confused. I don't know what's happening. And, I'm coming to pick the stuff up. So, it's my valuables. I have to pick them up.
Caused you to make decisions about your career and what you're going to do with it?
Right. Like I said, I'm lost right now. I'm confused. I don't know what's happening. All I know is two people jumped me in the ring, and I come down to my dressing room, to shower up and be ready to leave, because as you can see, they laced me wide open, and the door's shut, all my valuables are strewn out on the floor. You know, I'm just, I didn't understand it. I didn't know what was going on. I was just confused. I was lost. Here I'm trying to get in. The door's never shut. They never shut the door. Here I am trying to get in. I don't understand it.
You never got any chance to explain what happened?
No, I didn't. No explanation. No explanation. I was locked out of my own dressing room. That's all I know. I was locked out. My stuff was thrown out. And like I said, me and Humbert Dink had had a few words, you know, in the past, you know, recently, but I didn't think they were this serious, but I guess they are this serious. That's the picture right there. That's all I know of right there. That's all I know. And I'm not saying, you know, I'm not guilty of anything I've done in the past. You know, like five of us jumped Blackjack Mulligan and beat the man up severely. You know, I'm not saying I wasn't involved, but as it seems right now, you know, what goes around comes around, as right there in Lakeland proved it. You know, Superstar Billy Graham and Cowboy Ron Bass, from the orders, I'm sure, of Oliver Humbert being jumped me from behind. And somewhere down the line, you know, I'm going to get these two men in the ring somewhere down the line, and whether it's tags, if I get me a good tag team partner, anybody, you know, or I can take them on singles, but Superstar Billy Graham, Cowboy Ron Bass, Oliver Humperdinck, them three men right there, the main three men that jumped me from behind, they split me wide open, them three men right there is the one I'm looking for, and I know, Miss Claire, that there's an underlying evil force much stronger than these three men. I know there's a much evil force, and I think we all know who I'm talking about. I don't have to mention any names. This man's been on the scene, you know, causing things evil to happen for a long, long time. And that night in Lakeland, you know, the evil in that dressing room, you know, with Humperdinck, Kevin Sullivan, the evil is so thick over there you can cut it with a knife, you know. Like, I was confused all the time. I've been over there for months and months, night after night. I was confused. I didn't realize what was going on. And in Lakeland this Saturday night, Dusty Rhodes was the first man ever to show me that I could stand on my feet like a man on my own, because I always had Humperdinck or Sullivan or somebody there saying, you know, one man gang, you do this, you do that, you know, like I always had like a little, they was leaning post for me. But that night was the first time ever in my life that I found out I could stand on my feet like a real man should stand on his feet.
Well, in view of the situation, Dusty Rhodes had some comments to make, so now let's put this
on. Let me tell you something, gang. Now, the words come down, you got thrown out of your home, your house, the dressing room. I mean, you're walking down the hall, I heard, with your equipment in your hand. Now, a few months ago when this started, when I broke your leg, I tried to tell you in a violent matter how it was between me and the family and them guys over there. See, and any time, I haven't spoken to the family about this thing, and you've called for me to be your partner. Well, I've always done what I wanted to do and with who I wanted. You know how bad I can get. You know how really mean and ornery I can get. So I know one thing, if it's time for you to break loose and come right, then our family's always accepted anybody that wanted to come right. And I'm just gonna make it real plain and simple. I'll be your partner. And if you're serious about coming right, you'll have a family, and you won't have a dressing room to be thrown out of. You'll have one to live in and socialize in and be part of. But if you don't come right, and it's bad judgment on my part, Bobby ain't gonna like it. Barry ain't gonna like it. Billy Jack ain't gonna like it. And Dusty Rhodes and his sister ain't gonna like it. Because now you know how it feels, Daddy. So I'll show up, you do your part, and the family will do theirs.
That's the American dream, and that's our take five for this week.
Your hottest ticket to a week of rock and roll is right here. solid gold hits keeps the beat hot. With Christopher Cross, Tina Turner, Men at Work, Missing Persons, and the Human League on stage. Plus, videos from Rick Springfield, Jefferson Starship, The Alan Parsons Project, and Weird Al Yankovic. First, we'll kick you head over heels with a double play from the Go-Go's. Plus, Live Again lip syncers that'll have you begging for more all week with solid gold hits.
Monday at 6 on WCIX Channel 6.
Waiting now for the appearance of the breakdancers, and believe you me, they are a challenge, these breakdancers. Buddy, this will be your first opportunity to see them in action, but there's something else.
Well, you know, I have heard about them in the past, but it's my first time.
And as they come out, a little breakdancing going on the floor. Indeed, the breakdancers against the Infernos 1 and 2. One fall, a 10-minute time limit. They're an extremely muscular pair of athletes. Referee Bill Alfonso sending them back to their corner. They stay in constant movement.
You know, Gordon, I've been reading about these men in all the wrestling magazines. I've heard a lot about them throughout the years, but this is the first opportunity I've had to see them. And I hear they are a very exciting team. He's getting off to a very fast start here.
The Inferno lashes out, caught him with a boot in the midsection after two quick takedowns. Good. High leapfrog into a drop kick by the breakdancers. Tag is made. And as the Inferno tried to explode a couple of right hands to the midsection very quickly. Brought him up into a full body slam. High backdrop. This is a Russian leg sweep. Very, very effectively. A quick move over. Came out of it on the count of two, however.
Well, you know, Gordon, they are constant action. They're always in motion here, constantly moving, staying close to their corner where you can't have those fast tags. Big high flying drop kick right upside his chin, up his right on the side of the forehead.
Down to three. And the breakdancers may have set a new tag record. As I said, they are indeed a challenging team. Take a moment now to talk about wrestling this coming Wednesday night in Miami Beach at the Miami Beach Convention Center. The Florida Heavyweight Championship goes on the line. Dusty Rhodes going after superstar Billy Graham. In a special grudge match, it will be the one-man gang against Cowboy Ron Bass. In a bunkhouse match, Blackjack Mulligan and Chief Joe Lightfoot face Black Bart and Angelo Mosca. Barry Windham takes on Kevin Sullivan. The Guerrero brothers will be there. And there'll be a host of other great matches taking place on the 14th. Correction, the 18th, I'm sorry. Now then, on Saturday the 21st, championship wrestling will be held in Fort Lauderdale at the Sunrise Musical Theater. Championship Wrestling presents A Night with the Stars and a special challenge. Dusty Rhodes and the one-man gang face superstar Billy Graham and Cowboy Ron Bass. If Dusty wins, he gets 5 minutes alone with Sir Oliver Humperdinck. There'll be a host of other great matches. We'll tell you more about those later on. Right now, let me talk to Blackjack Mulligan and Chief Joe Lightfoot about Wednesday night in Miami, a bunkhouse match. Anything goes.
Anything goes, Mr. Sully. Un petit Canadien français, tous les Haïtiens de langue française. C'est un bon chaos match, c'est un match que tout va. Prendre les chaises, les ceintures, les bottes de cowboy. On se bat comme on se bat dans les rues. Ça va le mec va se passer. Ces deux individus, right? Maintenant, on fait tellement de dommages en Floride. On s'est déplacé énormément de lutteurs. C'est toi ici, Blackjack Morgan et moi-même, on va aller là pour essayer de faire un peu de justice en Floride.
Well, it just so happens that Broken Feather agrees with everything that the little chief says. The little chief ain't never been in a bunkhouse, so I took him down out behind the ranch house. I said, teach us the bunkhouse, and here's what goes on. After about the 13th Jack Daniels bottle across the head, the little chief is ready. So Angelo Mosca and Black Bart, you had better be ready like you never be before. Come dressed like you always do. I don't know what you people in Massachusetts do. I got a pretty good idea. And Bart, he always dressed like a pig anyway. So come on and show up as you are. Fuck ass rules. Someone will get hurt in Miami.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Let's listen to these comments now from Angelo Mosca and others of his ilk.
Mr. Botany 500 over there talking about somebody dressing like a pig. Well, Mulligan, I'm going to have you know one thing, that I was born of tradition and nurtured by pride. I'm the man who walks and talks from the street. I don't know anything about no bunkhouse or a cowhouse, but there's a lot of chips to be thrown around. You better get your boots on because it's going to be deep and thick. Because when you're so nervous, Mulligan, and you look up at me and you see Black Bart and we look right in that seaside speaking at en français, we're going to make him say, Mosca and Bart are the greatest two wrestlers the NWA has ever seen today.
Saturday night, the 21st of July, Sunrise Musical Theater, a night with the stars. You got it right. Big match on that card. Ronnie Bass and superstar Billy Graham stepping into the ring with Dusty Rhodes and that country bumpkin oaf, the one-man gang, the man I kicked out of camp. I don't want nothing more to do with him. I fired him on the spot. One-man gang and Dusty Rhodes. Quite a combination. I never thought I'd live to see it. But we're going to see it on the 21st at the Sunrise with a little special stipulation. Has me upset, has me worried. If Rhodes' team wins, the one-man gang will get 5 minutes alone with me. I want you to guarantee me right now. It won't happen. Don't let that big old put his hands on me, Bass.
You know something? I carried the man for a while. I made him a United States Tag Team Champion with me. But the man couldn't hold up his end, like you say, Hop. The man is incompetent. So your incompetence has cost you, brother. And we'll see you Saturday night right here, brother.
Ain't gonna happen, Hop.
Well, first of all, you got him Wednesday night in Miami Beach at the Convention Center, you and the one and Cowboy Ron Bass one-on-one.
That's right. Wednesday night at the Convention Center, Cowboys 101. But what I want to talk about is Sunrise, Saturday night, Sunrise Musical Theater in Fort Lauderdale. You know, I went and asked the American Dream. I asked the man, I said, would you be my partner? The man put me out for 5 weeks. There's no man alive that's ever done that. The man is tough, so I asked him, would you be my tag team partner against these two men? Because all they know how to do is back jump, and it's not too much of a fair fight, 2 and 3 on 1. And American Dream said, sure, gang, I would take you as your partner, you know. You don't have too much trust right now, but I'm telling you right now, Dream, I won't turn my back on you, and I expect the same from you. The Cowboy Ron Bass, the superstar Billy Graham, when we finish up, when the American Dream and myself finishes with you, and one of these laid out, and we got the pinfall, I get 5 minutes with Sir Oliver Humpeldinker.
You've both worked hard to establish a wonderful way of life. But what if one of you were no longer in the picture? Luckily, you have total way of life coverage from Independent Life. It protects your total lifestyle, so that you can go on living in the manner to which you've grown accustomed. When an agent from Independent Life calls, talk to him about Total Way of Life.
People really get into Tuesday night baseball with the New York Yankees on WCIX Channel 6.
Out people are moving in. There's the pitch.
The Rangers stand beating eastward. Take on the New York Yankees Tuesday night baseball at 8:30 on WCIX Channel 6. Go ahead, get into it.
Well, it's obvious, buddy, they've lost one member of their group in the one-man gang, but it appears to me that Kevin Sullivan is drifting farther and farther over the edge.
You know, Gordon, it's very strange, this evil force that seems to surround Kevin Sullivan. I don't really understand it, so I can't really elaborate on what it is with this man. He's so strange and unpredictable. But nevertheless, he is a dangerous man, in or out of the ring.
No question about it, and he has a way of psyching his opponents as well. Let's take a look at a recent time when Kevin Sullivan approached the ring at the Lakeland Civic Center. Well, there you see him approaching, along with Sir Oliver Humperdinck. Huge boas around their necks, and it has to be an awesome and a frightening sight to any opponent who's about to face him in the ring.
When you see a 15-foot-long boa can stick around, now what's this? This is something I haven't seen before myself. Who says that he's leading?
Well, it's just another example of the sphere of influence that he controls.
but he's constantly out to manipulate people through their mind or in any way that he can. And,
frankly, there isn't much left to be said. Can be said about this, except that the man is obviously extending his sphere of influence and is getting more and more into the occult. And we can see here his Satanistic-looking assistants. And Sir Oliver Humperdinck appears to be very much a part of all of this.
This woman is with him, I really have no idea. I've never seen her before, but obviously she's under his complete control and she's dominated by Kevin Sullivan, just like many other wrestlers have fallen prey to.
Here at the Sportatorium, Kevin Sullivan in the ring, getting set to move out against Sullivan going gray, and Sullivan wasting no time whatsoever.
Well, Sullivan just attacked Golden Boy Jerry Gray before Jerry even realized the bell had wrapped about any ring. Kevin Sullivan is just out to injure and maim as many people as quickly as possible. And right now, Jerry Gray is in a danger just out here on this hard, solid concrete floor.
A lot of pain now as Sullivan putting punishment after punishment on top of him.
Well, this form of a backbreaker is just there's a lot of pain there. It really shatters the disc in your back, and it's all over for Golden Boy Gray.
Let me get over there and have a word with him.
See this evil, satanic look on Kevin Sullivan's face, and Gordon Foley is going over to have an interview with Kevin Sullivan. Let's go to Gordon Foley at ringside.
Mr. Sullivan, there has been a lot of comment that you seem to be slipping farther and farther over the edge.
I'm slipping farther and farther over the edge. That is not the truth. First of all, the so-called giant one-man gang, do not cross me. You're not the only giant that I put under. You know, you're talking about me slipping. I'm going to tell you something. After the last ever hangman's noose match, where Mulligan and I both survived, and I do not know how he survived, because when I reached up and pulled the noose down and put it over his head and cinched up, I could hear the death wagon start to roll. But somehow, he escaped, because that night he had a power that I couldn't defeat. There was some kind of power that he had that night that he drew, and he got away. I was summoned that evening to the temple by Habudadina himself, and after much feasting and after much rejoicing, Habudadina gave me the betel nut to chew on. And as I chewed upon the nut, things got clearer. And I asked Habudadina himself, I said, please, give me something to destroy the family. Because the head of the family, Blackjack Mulligan, has a power that even I cannot understand. That he draws upon this power from someplace I cannot even understand it. I asked and begged Habudadina, I said, Master, give me the key. Give me the key that will destroy the family. Take the head down. And he laughed with glee. And he told me, you do not need the key, because I have the lock. I am the keeper of the lock. So Mulligan, after the beetle nut had cleared, and I had seen his truth, I have realized that, yes, you are a mortal man. And yes, yes, Mulligan, yes, you are weak for the flesh. I will bring you the luck. And you will be mine, Mulligan. You have taken a step too far this time.
Not the key, but the lock. Very interesting. We'll be back. Two great nights of wrestling upcoming. First of all, wrestling this Wednesday night in Miami Beach at the Miami Beach Convention Center. The Florida Championship goes on the line. Dusty Rhodes after superstar Billy Graham. One-man gang in a grudge match against Cowboy Ron Bass. There'll be a bunkhouse match, Blackjack Mulligan and Chief Joe Lightfoot against Black Bart and Angelo Mosca. Barry Windham takes on Kevin Sullivan. There will be four other matches. Now, here's Barbara Clary.
Miércoles, el 18 de julio, a las 8 de la noche, en el Centro de Convenciones en Miami Beach, la lucha libre de campeones presentará para el título de Florida, Dusty Rhodes contra Superstar Billy Graham y siete luchas más. Miércoles, el 18 de julio, a las 8 de la noche, en el Centro de Convenciones en Miami Beach.
And then, of course, Saturday night, championship wrestling does come to Fort Lauderdale in the Sunrise Musical Theater. That'll be match time at 8 p.m. Championship Wrestling presents A Night with the Stars. It's time now for our missing children's bulletin of the week. And we have two missing juveniles this week that we would like to bring to your attention. This is Yolanda Dorian Laird. She is 5 years old. She was last seen on October 6, 1981 in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. She was in the company of her non-custodial father, Carl Ellis Laird, a 34-year-old black male. They may be in the vicinity of Louisville, Kentucky, or Columbus, Ohio. If you have any information, please call toll-free 1-800-342-0821. Our second missing juvenile is Marjorie Christina Luna. She's also known as Christy. She is 8 years old. She has a slight speech impediment and hearing problem. She was last seen on May 27th of this year at the Belk's General Store in Green Acres City, Florida. She is, unfortunately, they suspect foul play in this case. Anyone having any information on this little girl, please again call the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, 1-800-342-0821. That's 1-800-342-0821. This is a six-man tag team match we've been talking about and loving. They didn't waste any time waiting for introductions. They're getting it on right now.
Well, in a match like this, you're going to expect a lot of excitement. Normally, you won't see the people getting out there mixing up like this. Who's losing the match? For these six competitors, it's going to be just a great match. The referees right now seem to have already lost control of the entire match.
Barry Windham moving back into the center of the ring. Bill Alfonso finally getting four men out and leaving two men in. Angelo Mosca and Barry Windham, and it's Mosca. Going on an elbow. Barry Windham, a beautiful cross body block. And referee Bill Alfonso caught an elbow in the rib.
You know, in a match like this with six men in there, that referee really has to be careful and try and sail the way as best he can. See where they use the rope for animal momentum and speed. Here comes Black Bart in the ring to try and break that pinning combination up that Barry Windham had on Cowboy Ron Bass.
Hey, Blackjack Mulligan moves in now against Cowboy Ron Bass. Caught him in the back of the elbow. Bass' son makes the tag with Black Bart. Six-man tag team action. Chief Joe Lightfoot is out. Lightfoot now with beautiful tomahawk shot. And Lightfoot exploding but got trapped in the corner.
Well,
Chief Joe Lightfoot is in a dangerous position now over in the corner of men like Angelo Mosca, Black Bart, and Ron Bass. They will be doing their very best to keep him there in that corner until they can defeat this man.
Lightfoot caught with a snap there. Black Bart punishes him some more on the canvas. Mr. Oliver Humperdinck and superstar Billy Graham watching the match with a great deal of interest from outside.
It seems like Sir Oliver Humperdinck has been trying to align quite a few different wrestlers to have in his camp or under his wing or under his influence. Well, it looks like here.
Wait a minute. Superstar Billy Graham, the karate blow to the throat. Superstar Billy Graham has just entered the ring. The referee calling for the bell. The referee calling for the bell. Superstar Billy Graham. And hold on a second. Here comes the one-man game. The one-man game on that ring. We've got a fierce waterfront brawl going here. Cleared the ring. We'll be right back. Hector and Chavo Guerrero moving into the ring now, getting set to go against Scott McGee and Dennis Brown. Mike Rotundo, co-holder of the U.S. Tag Team Championship, along with Barry Windham, is joining me here at the desk. And obviously a good chance to do some scouting, because these men have got challenges out there.
That's exactly right, Gordon. You know, this is a great opportunity where I can sit and watch the every move of the Guerreros, because Barry and I do have some upcoming matches. And we're going to look at a very exciting match right here today of two capable opponents.
Beautiful sit-out and reversal by Scott McGee on Chavo Guerrero, and a good ride by McGee. Guerrero trying desperately to get away from it, cannot. McGee stays right on top of him.
That's good. Scott McGee has a great wrestling background, being from England, being a former champion in England, and also having a very successful career in professional wrestling, Gordon. This is a man that, along with Denny Brown, who I think is one of the most improved wrestlers in the country right now, and the Guerrero brothers are obviously a sneaky, sneaky team, and you have to watch their every move, Gordon.
Question about that. Chavo Guerrero moves out once again, collar and elbow. This time it's Scott McGee with a side headlock.
You know, any match I've ever seen with the Guerrero brothers has always been exciting. It's a very colorful tag team. All four of these men in the ring are quite well versed in the professional wrestling skills. They've all had a great background. They've all traveled around the United States, around the world. Chavo Guerrero seems like.
You can see right there, Gordon.
Scott McGee just kind of lost his balance there and went down. He wasn't really thrown down. He lost his balance going into this turnbuckle. And consequently, he is at a serious disadvantage now with a full Nelson and a reversal on the full Nelson.
Good reversal on McGee, and behind him once again gets the full Nelson.
That's an unusual situation there, Gordon. McGee is countering these wrestlers very well. Right there, he gives a tag to Fresh Man and Denny Brown. They're working that headlock right now.
Denny Brown brings him up into a full body slam. Looks that near leg, and Chavo Guerrero back to his feet.
That was a good move by Denny Brown there. He slammed, he covered him with a punch.
Denny Brown seems to miss that time.
I think the referee saw them.
Couldn't have, and Chavo Guerrero gets credit for a pin here. Chavo Guerrero getting credit for a pin. Now the two of them setting off on. Wait a minute. Rotundo in his street clothes just. Rather.
seen some great action here today on Championship Wrestling 84. Joining me here at the desk now is Sir Oliver Humperdinck and Superstar Billy Gray.
I just wanted to come out to clear the air about a few things. I heard this big old country bumpkin stumbling goof Oaf, the one-man gang out here, saying how confused and dazed he is. So I'm going to eliminate all the dazed and confused right now. The one-man gang, as of that night in Lakeland, is no longer with me. He is fired. He has been terminated. We are walking different paths. You understand what I'm saying? No more confusion, one-man gang. You're through. I don't want to see you again. I don't want to talk to you again. I don't even want to be in the same arena with you. I've got no time for incompetence. This man is incompetent.
He's stupid. He's a jerk. And one man gang, Superstar Billy Graham, is the king of the Full Nelson. Superstar Billy Graham is the king, you understand, of the bells, the man with the 22-inch pythons. And if you ever get in my face again, one man gang, you're going to fall like a giant redwood. A 300-foot tall redwood fall to the ground with a karate chop.
There it is, Superstar. 700 pounds right there, baby. One man gang. Listen up now. Listen real good. Draw your chair up to the TV set right here. And listen to this. You were right when they said there's lines being drawn. You're right when they said there's so much evil on this side. Well, I live with evil. I walk with evil. And I talk with evil. And gang, we'll see.